math isn't difficult. Math is fun. I am Neelakanta Bhanu Prakash and I am the fastest human calculator in the world. And we are Exploring Infinities. Exploring Infinities is here in front of you to give you a mathematics learning experience like never before. With expert trainers from around the country, we are here to make you learn math.
Hello everyone, welcome back. So in the last video we ended with this question, so let's solve this now. So if you look at your table, then tan 30 value is 1 by root 3. So tan 30 is equal to 1 by root 3 and tan 45 is 1, right? So 2 tan 30 is 2 into 1 by root 3 by tan 45, right? Tan 45 is 1, so that is 1 plus 1 square, right? So 2 into 1 by root 3 by 2, so it is 1 by root 3, right? So that is how you solve any question that is given to you based on angles. So now let's move ahead. So there is something called complementary angles. You might have already studied about it. What are complementary angles? Complementary angles are angles whose sum is 90 degrees. So if there are two angles, their sum should be 90 degrees. So if this is A, B, C, then angle A plus angle C is 90 degrees, right? Because this is a right angle triangle. So that means angle A and C are complementary. So now we'll use this concept in trigonometry. And how will we do that? We'll do that in this way. So you know that sine of angle A, we already know that sine of angle A is cos of angle C. How? So this is how. Because sine of angle A is opposite by hypotenuse and cos of angle C is adjacent by hypotenuse. So the ratio is same. So the angle will be same. So we can also write cos C as, because A and C are complementary angles, A plus C is equal to 90 degrees. Right? So C can be written as 90 degrees minus A. Right? So cos C can be written as sine of 90 minus A. Cool? So that is how you can write an angle. And now, this is how you depict. Sorry, you can write a sine of 90 minus C. Sorry, sine of 90 minus C is A. So, wait. Sorry. So cos C can be written as cos of 90 minus A, right? Because C is 90 minus A. So now how do you know, now what can you see? Sine A is cos of 90 minus A, right? So these are complementary angles. So just like that, when you look at the other values also, you can say that sine comma cos, cosecant comma secant, tan comma cot, these three are complementary pairs. So what does that mean? It means that sine of 90 minus this angle is cos, cosecant of 90 minus theta is secant theta, tan of 90 minus theta is cot theta, like this. So if there's a question, then always look forward to look towards making this angle complementary. So I'll just show it with an example. Like, look at this example. Cos 7a is equal to sine a minus 6. When you look at this, it's very difficult to solve. Why? Because it's cos and sine, so we can't solve this. So now I'll try to convert this cos into sine. How will I convert this? Cos theta is equal to sine 90 minus theta. right? So that is sine 90 minus a 7a is equal to sine a minus 6, right? So sine is same, so you cancel. So 90 minus 7a is equal to a minus 6, right? So 90 minus 6 is equal to a plus 7a. So 90 minus 6 is 84 is equal to 8a. So a is equal to 10.5. So that is how you calculate. Or let's look at another question. Sine b plus c by 2 is equal to cos a by 2. We need to prove this. Okay, so how do you prove this? Now you look at a triangle a b c, right? So b plus c by, so a plus b plus c is equal to 90 degrees, right? So b plus c is equal to 90 minus a. So b plus c by 2 is equal to 90 minus a by 2, dividing by 2 throughout. So how do you write this? Sine of 90 minus a by 2 is equal to cos a by 2. Like sine of 90 minus a by 2. You can write this as that. And now let's convert this to cos. Sorry, this is 180 degrees, right? Sum of angles is 180. So this is 180 by 2. So that is 90 minus a by 2. So sine 90 minus a by 2 is what? Cos a by 2. So clearly LHS is equal to RHS. So that is how you solve questions. Now I'll give you a question which you can try to do as homework, and then we'll try to solve it in the next class. Find the value of tan 48, tan 16, tan 42, tan 74. You have to find its value. So let's solve this in the next class.
And so we come to an end to today's lecture. Thanks a lot for watching this, and stay tuned for the upcoming ones. Don't forget to follow @fastesthumancalculator and @exp.infi on Instagram, and subscribe to our YouTube channel.